wholeheartedly I give my life, Lord, to you. In everything I say and live and do, may my life be a reflection of Jesus and his direction. Wholeheartedly I give my life, wholeheartedly to you.
Hello and welcome to Wholeheartedly Bible and Music Publications. My name is Hannah Yao, and I'm so glad that you're here with us today and that you've taken the time to learn a little bit more of God's Word and hide it in your heart. And if you are wondering why I wasn't here last week, I apologize for missing that, and I appreciate your patience with me. And I've been having a lot more migraines. I suffer from chronic migraines, and I've been having a lot more lately. And also, I was just trying to keep my priorities of things in my home running smoothly, and so I appreciate your patience, and I'm glad to be back with you this week. And so the verse that we're going to be looking at this week is Philippians 4:19. But before we get to that, I want to share with you a very special person in my life, and that is Bella. And I got to meet Bella's family about 8 years ago. And before Bella was even born, Bella's mom was expecting Bella and her brother. And we were able to meet them while we were out. Their family was on our bus route. And so we picked up three of her older siblings, and their mom allowed us to become a very big part of their lives. Anyway, we have remained close now that they even live in Kansas. And the kids come and visit us during the summer, and we see them at Christmas time, and we still stay in touch. And so Bella's here with us right now during the summer, and we're glad of that. And so anyway, I thought it might be a good time to share with you what we talk about sometimes about teaching young ones to hide God's word in their hearts. And Bella's already been doing a good job of that. She was sharing with me, remember in children's church, she blessed my heart the other day. And she said, Miss Hannah, she made my day. She said, Miss Hannah, the thing I remember about Turner's Church is, and she didn't realize that it was a verse, but it was Ephesians 4:32, and it was be kind. And she started singing the song, and it, of course, that blessed my heart. And anyway, Bella is an encouragement to me, and I love her to pieces. And so anyway, we are going to talk a little bit about Philippians 4:19 today. And that verse says, you want to read it together? It says, but my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And so that verse and that scripture is teaching us that God, he loves us so much that it doesn't say that he might, it says he shall supply our needs. And I learned this scripture as a youth, and there's been so many times that I have needed something, and the Holy Spirit has brought this scripture to mind when I was needing it. And I started singing this song once again, and but my God shall supply your need according to not my riches, but according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And those riches belong to him and what he can supply, and he owns the cattle on 1,000 hills, the wealth in every mind. He has wealth beyond what we know. And, you know, sometimes we think about the, you know, the needs that we have financially or a monetary thing that we might need, and you know, how we're going to put food on the table or shoes on feet and clothes on back. And sometimes we might think about something that we need, and then those things pile up. And, you know, Bella, how many brothers and sisters do you have? She's counting them. She has a lot. She's using all her fingers.
Sierra, Serenity, 4, Carlos, Jeremiah, Jasmine, 6.
6. And so there's a lot of needs when you have that many siblings. And so...
7.
And so, right? And so, so when you have that many siblings, you have a lot of needs, and the needs can pile up because one child says, "Oh, I need this, and Mom, can you get it when you go to the store?" But then somebody else comes and they say, "But Mom, I need this," and then it's just a trickle effect. But if we go to God for our needs, then He will always supply, won't He? Yes, that's right. So no matter what our needs are, then He's going to supply it, isn't He? That's right. And then it's not according to our riches, because our riches run out, but God's riches never run out. But, you know, a lot of times when we think about this verse, we think about riches and money, but it also has to do with needs of the heart. You know, sometimes we may have a need of a friend, and you know, we may have lost a friend because they moved away, or we may have lost a friend because of health and they may have passed away, or we may have lost a friend because they chose a different path, and we may have a need, and God may be saying, we may have to go to God and say, "Lord, I have this need, and You can supply my needs," and He's always right there. And He's ready according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. And so whatever our needs are, He's ready and He's waiting to be our Father. And just like our Father supplies our needs, and we go to Him and ask Him for that, God is ready to supply our needs, isn't He? And so, because I have Bella here with me, then I'm going to put some motions with this song. So we'll do... God for God, but my God shall supply, like He gives to us, shall supply all your needs. So like He gives it back to us, okay, according to His riches. And we'll do riches like it's money, but it doesn't always money that He gives us. It could be anything else that he decides is His abundant things that He gives us, okay, in glory, because that's in heaven, glorious heaven, okay, by Christ Jesus, like He died on the cross. So, but my God shall supply, like He gives it to us, all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Very good. All right. So we've done this about, when I've sung it to her probably 5 or 6 times. So we're learning this together. So we will sing this for y'all, and hopefully y'all can learn this with your little ones, and you'll enjoy this, and we sure have enjoyed learning it together, haven't we? And it's getting kind of late here. So anyway, are you ready? All right. Let's do this. But my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. But my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I'm so glad you came here today, and I'm so glad to have Bella with me, and I hope to see you again next week.
I hope the Lord uses something that I've said today to be a blessing and a help and encouragement to you, and that it will draw you closer in your walk with Him. And if something that I've said has been a blessing to you, I hope you'll hit the like button and subscribe so that you don't miss any lessons in the future. And I hope to see you back again real soon. May we all be living lives that are wholeheartedly for Him.
Wholeheartedly I give my life.